Grizzlies were also very shorthanded in that particular game. Randolph on the feed to Gasol. Back down, up and in. Over Patrick Patterson. Interesting that they did not choose to guard Marc Gasol with Jonas Valanciunas, but rather with Patrick Patterson, who's more of a stretch four. Out on the floor with Marc Gasol. Gasol with an early three, trying to down. Gasol aggressive early. They're 30th in the league. The Raptors are 27. Two teams that start pretty slow with Gasol. Pretty move. It's up. It's in. Well, you talked about in the effective dice of the game finishing in the paint. Case in point.
Well, yeah, two shots in the paint, two buckets down for Marc Gasol. And what you like here is there was never any indecision on was he going to score. The entire year has let them down, and Norman Powell has really struggled with his stroke.
Gasol's got an open look. It's a three for Gasol. He has 11 for Memphis. Gasol thought about the three and turned it down. Against Houston, he didn't try one from right around the logo. Instead, he'll put it on the deck.
Well, listen, they did switch Valanciunas.
Patterson guards Randolph. Valanciunas steps out against Gasol. Another three. And again. Marc Gasol.
Give that man more days off from games than just practice. He's put together a heck of a game already in the first 4 minutes.
Ross had 21 last night against San Antonio. Harrison covered up by Lowry. Gasol, yes. Gasol now 7 of 10 and 19 points in the quarter.
Nice quick find there by Harrison as Sullinger tried to play between two. Got to Marc Gasol quickly so Sullinger couldn't react to Valanciunas to make it tougher.
Grizzlies only 9 assists on 17 baskets. Gasol goes behind the back and gives the Grizzlies a lead 53-51.
In the post there.
Well, he didn't lean on Gasol. Gasol reined it in over his head. Gasol with 25.
Yeah, they allowed this team to have early success. You give teams that are struggling success early, they can continue to ride with, especially good offensive teams.
Gasol for three. It's three. Lowry now 3 of 5, I correct myself, from three. Gasol is 4 of 7 from three, and he has 28 points. Lowry now with 15. He's the high scorer for the Raptors. Gasol double. Fights through anyway and scores. He's got 30.
He faked the wraparound pass. Valanciunas went for the fake. So then Marc Gasol just said, let me just move him out the way and have this easy lay-in.
Andrew, you take Andrew's spot. Jay, go back. This, Mark.
Meanwhile, Damari Carroll and Lowry are out. Terrence Ross, Corey Joseph. Gasol! A new career high. His fifth triple tonight. And he triples the Grizzlies to a 73-70 lead. Well, Marc Gasol is not named an All-Star reserve tomorrow night. Some coaches are going to look awfully silly. Gasol, yes, in the third! Oh, big spin! He has been special tonight. Gasol, good again. 38 for Gasol, he ties his career high. And the Grizzlies escape 101-99. Rob Fisher with Marc Gasol, career night from him.
Yeah, Marc, congratulations on the win. Defensively, second, third quarter really held him at a lower percentage, did a better job on the defensive glass. What changed for you in the second half doing that?
He did a much better job on the ball, being aggressive on the initial action. That you know, allowed us on the help side to understand what's going on faster, so we can, you know, be more proactive defensively and be more disruptive.
With all the work and practice the last couple of days, you talked about simplifying things as well. How do you feel like it translated to the court?
Everybody was tied together. We made, you know, a lot of mistakes, especially in the first quarter, but, you know, we played through it. We believe, you know, guys started to figure, you know, more stuff out, and good win for us.
You couldn't miss in the first quarter. You got in a heck of a rhythm.
They stopped passing me the ball. I wanted to shoot some more, but they tried to ice me out.
last time we talked, you almost shot one from the bear. Tonight it looked a little further even. You thought about it for a second, but then you decided no.
I was open. I thought I was going to pull it, but it was a little too early in the game for me to shoot a half-court shot.
I know earlier this morning you said every game, every win's a big win, regardless of going on a six-game road trip. But it's got to feel a lot better getting on that plane tomorrow, coming off a win.
Without a doubt, obviously, when you win, everything feels much better. It takes care of a lot of stuff, a lot of little, mental breakdowns that we have. So, winning is always good.
Great game tonight, Mark. Thanks.
Thank you.